Hey everybody, Michael Pilofer back for another Movement Mobility episode on MSP Fitness TV. This is going to be part two on our series on the ankle. We established a nice video on assessment, which gave you some metrics of how to evaluate what kind of mobility you have right to left foot. Here we're going to take that a step further and now look to increase that range of motion. We're going to start off with the wall. Now from that, I'm just going to use my left leg as the guide. I'm going to keep that same perpendicular angle to the wall that we talked about back when we did the assessment piece. In this case, I'm going to straighten out the back leg, just use the wall for support. From here, I'm going to think about stepping into three vectors, kind of off to the pinky toe, in this case, straight over the front, and then off into the big toe. And I'm just going to call that one rep. I'll go off, up, and over. One rep. I'm going to do 10 reps of that. I'm going to switch to the other side, 10 reps of that. The key is heel must stay down and foot must stay perpendicular. Depending on where you're at for mobility, this heel may want to kind of play games with you. Don't let it. Keep it locked in. The second piece is going to be, now that I've established that straight leg stretch, I'm actually going to just simply bend at the knee and do the same three vectors. I'm going to drive it out over the pinky toe, straight over the middle toe, and out over the big toe. One rep, 10 reps of that, both legs. Call that a set. So that is a good place to start from that straight leg standpoint and that slight knee bend. If we want to work a little more power into the stretch, this would be kind of taking it to level two. I'm going to use the same wall, except now what I'm going to do is drive my foot or the ball of my foot high onto the wall. I'm going to think of the same exact stretches. In other words, I'm going to keep the leg straight and I'm going to now just drive my hip up over, I'm going to drive my hip straight in, I'm going to drive my hip up towards that big toe. Same three vectors. Same game now, if I was straight-legged, now I'm going to just bend the knee into those three vectors. I'm going to do 10 reps on one side, 10 reps on the other, for a total of 10 for all. Works great. So find which one. I'd probably start with the straight leg piece first. Once that feels like you get some movement and the ankle starts to open up a little bit, we can take it to the wall. Now here's an important consideration. As you're doing these stretches, if you're feeling some discomfort in the front part, which is where I see it most common with clients of ours, in that front part of the ankle, especially as you're coming straight on or more so kind of over into that pinky, we need to be cautious. You don't want to just keep jamming that. That's telling you that unfortunately you've got a little bit of an impingement in the front part of the ankle. There's a lot of little bones in there that need to glide over each other. So come on with me and I'll show you how we can work that. So I've set up a band against, you can put this on a door, or, you know, a lot of options within the home. And here I'm just going to attach it to our pull-up bar. What I'm going to do is bring the band in and put it really high, right at the point where kind of the front of the shin meets the ankle. And I'm going to walk my foot straight off so it's got some tension. What this is basically doing is kind of distracting my shin backwards, giving me a little bit more clearance for things to glide. Now I can do the same stretches that I did before, either driving the ankle into those three vectors or driving the hip across. So for those of you that have, for those of you that have some of that discomfort in the front part of the ankle joint as you're doing these stretches, don't push it. Don't crank on it. You're actually going to irritate tissues and create more trouble than it's worth. Use the band. Let things open up. Be patient. This takes time. So weeks, months. That's why also going back to that assessment piece and measuring can give you some tangibles of seeing where improvement is being made over time. So hey, thanks for watching the second of two episodes here on opening up the ankle and working some mobility. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel and check us out at MSP Fitness TV.